Today's video is about assets and liabilities. What they are, we'll look at their definitions and how we should budget and spend with our knowledge of these assets and liabilities. Please don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel for more videos on financial education, personal development, and money management. In very simple terms, an asset is anything that puts money in your pocket regularly, while a liability is anything which takes money from your pocket regularly. One of the basic and fundamental concepts of financial independence is understanding the difference between assets and liabilities. Asset brings money into your bank account, and liabilities do the opposite. They take money from you. And we, striving for financial independence, have to actively make every financial decision with the aim to increase assets and reduce liabilities. That with the aim to increase the money that comes into our pocket, that money that goes into our bank account regularly, as opposed to reducing that money. The more assets you can get, the more money flows into your bank account and the more financially independent you become. You know, every day in life, we use money for one purpose or another. You are either using money to buy something you need or something you just want out of necessity because other people want have it around you. You just want a new house because you got a promotion at work. You should have a house that befits you. You know, whatever the case, we use money. Now, as you do this, you need to be clear and mindful in your head how to use your hard-earned money. Right, is it that your hard-earned money, the money you have gotten from your hard-earned promotion, from your hard-earned bonus addition, how is that money buying you an asset, or is that money buying you a liability that will further decrease money from your bank account? These are questions you should answer every time you budget and spend. Like every time you decide to buy something, every time you consider buying something, every time your heart is drawn towards buying something, consider if that thing you want to purchase is an asset or a liability to you. Is it a liability that you can sustain? Because no matter what, we all have liabilities. But is it a liability that you can sustain? Is it a liability that you can avoid? Or is it a liability that you can turn into an asset? These are active decisions that you should think about with every purchase. Every time you budget your money and you want to spend your money, this is what it should be on your head. Is it an asset you're buying? Is it a liability? Is it a liability that you could turn to an asset? Is it a liability that you can sustain? Their current financial situation. Always need to be informed. That's why financial education is very important. You need to get information on how you should spend your money, on the things you buy. If you want a piece of land, get the information on that, if that land could be an asset to you or the land would just be a liability. Get information before you make every purchase. Get the information you need so that you can able to ascertain if whatever you're spending your money on is a liability to you, or it's an asset, or it's a liability that could turn into an asset. For example, car to Mary is an asset and to John is a liability. Now, John and Mary are two people. They work in the finance department. They all earn 500,000 francs per month. Now, Mary gets a promotion. John gets a promotion at his own office. Mary has the same promotion. Now they get a promotion and they get a salary increase of 100k. Right now, Mary has important meetings she has to meet up with. She cannot be hopping from taxi to taxi. She decides that she needs a car. Before Mary goes out to buy a car, she thinks of ways that she can make the car an asset, because she has to buy that car, she has to go to the bank and take a loan. Now, to take a loan to buy that car, such that her normal salary can sustain her and her normal expenses and her normal saving plans for as per normal, as she can save continuously with increasing saving capacity. Now she needs a loan, she goes to the bank. Now Mary is torn about going to the bank and making the car becoming a liability to her. Now, Mary is going through all these decisions in her head because she knows about assets and liability. She has a little bit of, right? Let's not say a little bit. She is financially educated, right? Mary knows and she is thinking about assets and liability. Now, Mary decides to go for the car. She needs her personal transportation. She needs to be able to leave the house when she has to leave. She needs to be able to go to meetings. And she needs to be presentable in a way. Now, Mary decides to get the car. Now, Mary buys the car. And this is what she does. Mary buys the car and she registers that same car in the public transport industry. And she hires a driver. Now, that driver does the job of a personal chauffeur and drives her around, takes her to work, takes her back from work, takes her to lunch, and takes her to her different meetings around town or out of town. Now, while Mary is at work, the driver works as a public transport, carrying other people around. So, Mary is at work doing her 9-to-5, while the driver is using that same time period working and earning another income for Mary. Now, Mary brings in the income from her job site, and the driver brings in another income from the transport business that he does during the period that Mary does not need the car. Mary has turned this liability to an asset because she had to borrow money to buy that car. She did the registration, that would cost money. She hires a driver, that's costing money. It's taking money from her pocket, right? Now, Mary is turning this liability into an asset. It serves her purpose for her personal transportation, and now it serves an additional purpose of bringing in its own income. Now, that car brings in income that takes care of the car maintenance, in income that takes care of the driver's fees, of the driver's salary, right? And Mary employed somebody. She creates employment. Isn't Mary just wonderful? Now, why Mary is at work, the salary at work comes in. She's happy with her bonus. The driver brings in a regular monthly income, right? So now Mary is left with two income. At times, as time goes by, Mary is able to use the income from her taxi business to buy herself a personal car at no risk. That's at no loan. She's not able to buy a personal car with no loan or with no strains to her financial situation. Now, her asset, let's say her liability that she turned into an asset, is able to buy her a personal car. Now, that is the way to think. That is the way to think. That is the way you need to think and look at every situation. Like even the phone you have in your hand now, or the laptop or the computer or the TV that you're listening to me through this, or you're watching this video. Is it an asset to you or is it a liability? These are the active decisions you should take with every step to know if what you have, what you are going to buy or you're budgeting for or you're spending your hard-earned money on, is it an asset or is it something that will just take more money from you with time? Now, let's look at the situation of John. John says, oh, I'm a dude. Pay increase. Yay. I think I should get a car. And he's like, the ladies love the car, and he's all like, and with an evil, stupid grin, I must say, sets off, goes to the bank, scrape up his account, and gets a loan on his account, and he gets a car, and the guy is cruising. He cruises it to work, and parks it there, and goes and stay in office from 9-to-5, and cruises it at 5, and go and park it in his house. He's cruising. He puts petrol into the car. He does maintenance. The car becomes a liability that takes from him. So this car will take from John for a long period of time. Now, John is like, do I really need this car? I need this car. The money to maintain this car is just too much. We are happy that John decides to really look at his financial situation and really look at his bank statement and decides and gives the thought. Oh, we are happy for John. But it's kind of already too late for John. Now, John thinks that, oh, I could sell the car. I could sell the car and get some money for it. So John leases the car up for sale. And he gets nothing, even up to half what he has spent to buy the car and maintain the car up to date. Just spent money to get the car and maintain the car up to date. And now that he's even thinking about something reasonable, cannot even get up to half the money he spent by reselling the car. Now, John and Mary, who is financially wise? John is, it's not wrong. There's nothing wrong in getting a car. If you can afford the car, you can get a car. It is good.
Like what Mary did after she turned her liability into an asset. Her asset got her a personal car without stress, and she still had the taxi that still gave her another income. In these two cases, we can see the notion of assets and liabilities in play. And that is why financial education is very important to make money decisions. Mary was in the know. She knew about financial education. She knew about assets and liabilities. That is why she even knew that she could turn that liability to an asset. But what if you don't know something? You will never even think about ways of arranging it. Because if Mary did not know about assets and liability, she would not even sit there and be thinking, I could get the money and buy the car and turn it into a taxi and let the taxi work for me for a period of years. You see, Mary had the bigger picture in mind, while John was just about the moment. I need the car for the moment. I cannot go to meetings from taxi to taxi or taking a bike. I need a car. A promotion, big office. I need a car. You see, John was just in the moment, while Mary was looking at the bigger picture. And because of her financial education and what she knew about how to spend money, how to budget it, and her knowledge on assets and liability, she was able to think that way. Right, and she ended up now with two sources of income plus a personal car that she did not have to pay a dime for. Not that she did not have to pay a dime for, she had to pay a dime for, but she paid for it without stress. As opposed to John, who now has nothing, who is now cannot even sell the car that he has for even up to half the amount he has spent on the car for the long number of years he has used. With the information and knowledge that Mary had about assets and liability, she was able to get two incomes while putting in time just for one. With these assets, Mary had two incomes while she did just time for one income, right? That's the notion of detaching time from income. Mary was able to detach time from income because she got an asset that worked while she did not. Right? With the notion of time detachment by using asset, the possibilities are endless. You could scale so high with assets. That is why you need to be able to develop that mindset of looking at things in terms of assets and liabilities. Actively seek out ways you can get assets that will put money to your pocket while you do something else, or you relax, or you do your normal 9-to-5 job, or you just stay at home and sleep. Right? Thank you so much for watching. Do like and subscribe for more. See you in the next video. I believe in you.